This video will show how to add and configure outbound call routes for the Grandstream UCM series PBXs. Before you can configure any routes, you need to have added trunks, either analog, VoIP, or both. In this system, both types are present. We'll start by looking at the outbound routes. As you can see, there are currently four different routes configured, each one using a different dial pattern. The dial pattern is what determines what phone numbers are acceptable, as well as which route and trunk is used when placing an outbound call. The first route is used for emergency calls to 911. You can see that the dial pattern only accepts those specific digits. If someone were to dial 411, the call would not go through. By hovering the mouse cursor over the word pattern, you will get a pop-up that shows the different variables that can be used to specify the dial patterns. If we wanted to change this route to allow calls to both 411 and 911, we could change the pattern to either N11, the variable N accepts any digits from 2 through 9, or left bracket 4, 9, right bracket 11, which accepts only 411 and 911. You can also see that the privilege level for this route is set to internal. This corresponds to the privilege level set for the extensions on the system and allows you to restrict routes to extensions that have either the same or higher privilege level. In this case, we want every extension to be able to call 911, so the privilege level is set to internal. Finally, we can specify the trunks that are to be used for the outbound route. We have the option of using either the analog or VoIP trunks. We can also either strip or add digits to the number being dialed. This is used in cases where a company has a digit they use to place outbound calls, such as 9. In that situation, someone would dial 9 plus the number, and we would put a 1 in the strip box so that the 9 would be removed before the system places the call. Something that is important to note is that the number in the strip box indicates how many digits the system is removing from the dialed number, going from left to right. It is not telling it to remove any ones from the dialed number. The prepend box is used to specify any digits that should be added to the beginning of the dialed number before the call is placed. We will see an example of how this works in one of the other routes. The next route is used for local calls. The dial pattern looks for 7 digits. The first one is a number 2 through 9. The last 6 are numbers 0 through 9. The X specifies essentially any number. The privilege level is set to local, and that is also using analog trunks to place the call. The next route is used for long distance calls. The analog trunks used by this system require a 1 plus the number for these calls, but many people have become used to leaving out the 1 as cell phones do not require this. So we have created a route that will allow these numbers to be dialed without the 1. The digit pattern is for a standard area code plus number. The privilege level has been set to national, and the trunks have been set to analog trunks. We have put a 1 in the prepend box so that when the system dials a number, it will add a 1 to the beginning so that the call is able to go through. The last route is almost identical to this one in that it's used for long distance. However, the digit pattern is set with a 1 at the front so that someone would need to dial a 1 in order for this to be used. Finally, there is no route currently set up for international calls, but should one be needed, the pattern that could be used for it is 011 period. 011 is the prefix for international calls, and the period is a wild card, which accepts any number of digits following the 011. Creating a route for a VoIP trunk works the same way, with the main difference being that most VoIP trunks do not support local numbers and will also have a specific digit pattern that needs to be set that may not match up exactly with what you see here. This will vary depending on the provider. And lastly, the order of the routes determines which one is used when someone dials identical numbers. In this case, all the patterns are different, so the order doesn't really matter. But if you had, for example, different routes or different trunks that needed to have the same pattern, they would go from top to bottom to determine which one is used when a call is being placed.